We are launching our high-altitude balloon during the total solar eclipse. Our main payload is a 360-degree camera rig. This will allow us to look at the moon as it's going across the sun and to look down and see the shadow cast by the moon at the same time. And I'm interested to see how much shadow we're going to capture and what it looks like. Most maps show it as a circle, but the moon is not perfectly round. It has mountains and craters, and this simulation actually shows the jagged edges that the shadows should be casting. And the darkest shadows will be cast in the umbra. The umbra shadow only occurs at locations that are experiencing the total solar eclipse. The red line drawn on this map shows the path of totality. Everywhere else outside of this red line, but within the yellow circles, we'll see a partial solar eclipse. We don't live within the red line area, we live in the yellow circle area, so we had to pick a new location to launch if we wanted to be in totality. And we chose the Homestead in Nebraska. It's close to the center line of totality, and there are lots of great events that we want to share with you guys. And our balloon doesn't do well with trees, so Nebraska is nice and flat, and that should be pretty useful for recovering our balloon. And we ran hundreds of simulations, and the vast majority of the flights stayed within the path of totality. And we hope to be at about 20 kilometers in altitude. That should be above the clouds, but far enough away from our burst altitude to be able to catch the total solar eclipse. There's another balloon group launching there too, and they're part of NASA's initiative to launch 50 weather balloons from coast to coast to live stream the total eclipse. They don't have 360 cameras as far as we know, but you should be able to watch most of the eclipse across America if you go to their site, which we'll link down below. We're not going to be live streaming from our balloon, but we will try and live stream our launch and parts of the eclipse from the ground. There are going to be thousands of people at the Homestead watching the eclipse, our launch, and participating in NASA and Planetary Society events. So we may or may not have Wi-Fi or data connectivity, and we're going to try and stream as best as we can, and we put events down in the description for that too. And we're going to be sharing our experience along the way on social media as we take our trip out there, finish some of our final tests, and actually launch the balloon. Mostly we're going to be doing this on Twitter and Instagram. But after the eclipse is over, we're going to, of course, release our launch video and the 360 video, and we're going to release some videos on how to create a high-altitude balloon. But for now, we have to work on packing and driving out to the actual location. Let us know down in the comments below if you guys are going to be able to watch the eclipse, if you're going to any events or doing any photography or science experiments for it. One of the experiments I'm looking forward to most is NASA's going to have a chase plane. It's going to follow along with the moon's shadow, and this is going to allow scientists to have a longer time in totality. And they're going to be able to create a heat map of Mercury. We also made SciJoy shirts because we wanted to wear them at the ballooning event, but if you guys are interested in them, they're down in the description below. And let us know how your eclipse watching goes, and we'll see you next time.